All right, we're going to go back to the questions in just a minute, but now we'd like to welcome Kara Verno from the Rochester Museum Science Zone back to the show. Hi, Kara.
Hi, and Tim, too. Yeah.
Hi, Tim. What did you guys bring us?
So these guys here are what are called Uromastyx, or we also can call them spiny tail lizards. That's cool. Their other nickname that they have for obvious reasons.
The tail.
Yeah.
So where are these guys found and what kind of climate are they going to live in?
So these guys are found in Africa and Asia mainly, and they're desert species. So I know you have some experience with
bearded dragons.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yep. They are in the same family as a bearded dragon would be. So they're found in very hot, very arid, dry places.
Nice.
Okay, because of that, what is their diet like?
So they eat mainly vegetation, so plants. They'll eat some seeds in captivity as well. They can eat some animal matter, so insects, things like that, but they usually don't. They mainly eat plants and seeds.
Are these guys full grown, and will they get much bigger than that?
Yeah, these guys are full grown. So the female is the one that I'm holding here. Her name is Marie. Tim here has the male, who is Pierre. The males have a much brighter color and are a little bit larger, and the females are a little bit smaller.
Kind of similar to other animals that we've seen as well.
Yeah, absolutely. Things like ducks have the same. Yeah, have the same. Have the same thing.
Cool. So now this animal's called the spiny tail lizard. Does it use the spines to protect itself?
It does, it does. It can take this tail here and it can whip it at a predator if it needed to. It's a very heavy tail. It's actually quite heavy. They can use it to do some serious damage.
Now, because it has, we've seen some other animals like geckos and stuff that have that kind of big tail like that. Will this tail regrow or can it regrow if it gets bitten off?
It can't regenerate its tail and it actually can't drop its tail. So a gecko can actually drop its own tail. There's a reaction that happens between the base of their tail here, where they can drop their own tail if they're feeling threatened. These guys here can't do that, and they also can't regenerate their tail.
They just get grabbed by it. Interesting.
Now, do the lizards live in groups or alone? How do they live?
So in captivity, we definitely recommend that just one male per tank. They do get aggressive if there's more than one male. You can have up to two females in captivity for sure. In the wild, they don't live in huge groups, definitely smaller colonies.
So similar to what you're doing in a tank anyway.
Exactly.
So because these guys from the desert or live in the desert and there's not a lot of water, do they need water?
They've adapted to live without standing water, so they don't need a bowl of water that they can walk up to and drink out of. You're not finding very many puddles or lakes or anything in the desert, so they're used to that. They do lick water off of leaves and things like that, so you have to make sure that when you're feeding them greens that you do spray them down, and that's where they'll get their water. They've adapted to have these little glands here that help them to hold in the different minerals, and the salt deposits come out of their nose, actually, so you'll see a little bit of white around their nose.
Yeah, you were showing us that earlier, that it almost looks like he has a runny nose. Yeah, she has a runny nose on the
I remember I did basic training in Fort Bliss, and we'd get done on treks, and you'd have strips of white crystals from wearing your rucksack from sweating so much and the salt coming out. It's kind of the same kind of thing.
They call it snelt, which is actually pretty cute.
Cool. Well, thank you very much. And if you want to know more about this animal and others like it, go to our website, homeworkhotline.org, and click on videos. Stay right there. We'll be back in a second.